In 2000, I had bariatric surgery. I weighed 330 pounds, and then I lost 180 pounds. And if I had to do it over again, I wouldn't do it. My name is Robin Edds. I'm from Brownstown, Michigan, and I have been doing CrossFit for a year and a couple of months.
Hi, I'm Susan. I'm your trainer today.
I'm Robin.
Nice to meet you,
Robin. Nice to meet you.
Thanks for joining us.
Have you met Robin before?
Bariatric surgery is when they actually go in, they take my stomach and get rid of most of it by making just a really small pouch that's only an ounce or two. And then they actually take your intestines and reroute your intestines so you don't even absorb certain nutrients and you end up in where your body is actually being deprived of what it needs in order for you to lose weight. At 330 pounds, I couldn't do anything. Couldn't clean my house, couldn't barely take care of my kids. Walking was something I couldn't do. I was pretty much kind of an invalid even though I was able to walk. And when I finally got to 150 pounds, my fitness wasn't any better. I still really couldn't do anything. The only thing that was different was my clothes size. I still couldn't run. I really couldn't play. I couldn't really do anything with my kids. I just fit in the car better and I could go shopping with them. But as far as fitness, I was completely unfit and fairly unhealthy. So I was just getting sicker and sicker and sicker and couldn't do anything about it. I was no more well off at 150 than I was at 330, except for the ability to fit in a car and fit in a booth at a restaurant. But nothing really changed.
Hey, I don't want you jumping.
You've done that at 150 pounds?
No, I could not have done this at 150 pounds.
Now that I found CrossFit and I see how changing my diet and exercising and working worked so much better and I'm so much more healthy for it, if I could do it all over again, I would go back to my 330 self and I would start here. I would start with CrossFit, I would start with changing my nutrition, because right now some of the things that I do still have wrong with me are because of a choice that I made in 2000 to alter my structure, my organs, and you shouldn't do that. But now, I mean, I'm so much more fit since I started doing CrossFit. I eat a kind of a paleo zone kind of combination that works well for me, and I'm a whole lot more healthy. I can play with my grandkids. I can run and jump, and I feel amazing, and I am 50 years old. So now I've been CrossFitting for 1 year, and in that time, I've lost an additional 35 pounds, but it has drastically and amazingly changed my life. I went from being on a couch for 2 years to doing toes to bar, and I can sit up, and my main symptoms are in my hands and my wrists, and I can do things with my hands now that I couldn't do before. So that 35 pounds and that 1 year has made what I think the rest of my life is going to be a good place to be, whereas before I was just doing day to day. And now I'm excited about life.
People assume that people with rheumatoid arthritis or lupus or Sjogren's, that just carrying on a regular life, going to the grocery store, is all they're ever going to accomplish, and they're not really going to be able to do anymore. I'm not a disease. I'm a person that is just living with a disease. So I have to make my own life whatever I want it.
I got rid of half the medications. My rheumatologist is amazed that I can do the things that I can do. And I've gotten rid of all. I don't take pain medication anymore. I do still have to take one medication for my rheumatoid to keep it under control, but everything else is gone.
So you're saying in CrossFit, rheumatoid arthritis, so far since I've met you, the trouble that you're telling me that you have
is getting those clips in.
Not snatches.
No.
But clips.
Clips. I have my own clips that at home. I have the collars because I can work those, but I can't work these clips. They're too hard.
So I found CrossFit because my son, who is in the Marines, said, "Mom, please do this. I think that this is really your only help, you know, hope in order to get fitter and to be in a better condition." And so I said, I would do it. He begged me and for a year, and I wouldn't do it. I just said I couldn't do it. I just looked at videos, and there was no way I was going to be able to do it. So I was at my wit's end, and so I went ahead and did it. And I couldn't do 5 sit-ups. I couldn't do a push-up. I couldn't jump a rope. And I was at 150 pounds, but that's how unfit I was. And I said, all right, I'm going to stick with this. I'm going to give it 6 months. And I couldn't, very slowly, the gains were better and better and better.
So at 3:30, if I said, hey, you got to jump on that box, you would say,
I would just sit.
It's not even in the realm.
It's not even in the realm. Like, I would just laugh at you.
You would never have even thought that was
never
possible.
At 150 pounds, I wouldn't have been able to do it.
Okay, hold on. Let's back up for a second. At 330 pounds, if I said 180 pounds lighter, could you jump on that?
I would have then told you I could probably do that all day long. I thought when I had bariatric surgery that it was going to solve my fitness problems as well as my weight problems, and that didn't happen.
So at 150 pounds, it's kind of a rude awakening to, like, hey, yo, there's still a lot of work to be done.
Yeah, and I didn't do it for years and years and years. I just didn't do it. I thought this was it. This was my life.
How many years did you roll at 150 and unfit?
12.
Well, we started in like 2000 with the bariatric surgery, and I was like 13, cleaning, you know,
doing wound care,
making sure she ate right because it was like a strict diet in the beginning.
I encourage my daughter, she's 26 years old, to do it. She's like me. She's taller than me because I'm only 5 foot tall, but she has a tendency to gain weight, and it's hard for a mom with 2 kids, and I wanted her to never have the same problems that I had. I wanted her to get her fitness on early in life and stick with it and have a passion for it and have it be something that is part of her daily life so she never had to face any of the health problems or the weight problems that I've had.
I'm dying.
You're hurting?
I'll hurt later.
Tell me about that. What is CrossFit?
CrossFit is making my life 100% better. That's what CrossFit is to me. It just doesn't get any better.
My home box is CrossFit DownRiver. Hi, CrossFit DownRiver. And they've been great. And they understand that I've got some issues. There's a coach there named Nate. And he is always helping me, and the owner is great, and the people are all really nice, and it's a great place to be. It's a great environment. They do great things. My goal was to get off the couch and to be able to live a life like a normal human being. I wanted to be able to go to the grocery store. I wanted to be able to clean my house. That was my goal, and I've exceeded my goals, and now my goals are I'm going to get a higher box jump, and I'm going to lift more weights, and I'm going to live life to the fullest because now I have those capabilities because of CrossFit. I feel like I can do anything.